Ethics for me is the study of the good life, what it is, how we can achieve it, and then making sense of how technologies, robotics, and artificial intelligence impact our ability to achieve and to live the good life. We talk about privacy, sustainability, dignity. These are the values that make up the good life. My name is Aimee van Wynsberghe. My research is about how we can incorporate ethics into the design process of different technologies, in particular artificial intelligence and robotics.
Aimee van Wynsberghe examines which values are gaining in importance in a world shaped by technology and which social challenges are connected to this. How can innovation be promoted and social values be protected at the same time? What are the opportunities and challenges of intelligent systems?
We should understand that when AI is being used in society, it is very much a social experiment. We do not know the consequences, short or long term, about what will happen when it's used in different applications. Therefore, we should treat it like an experiment.
Ethics must play a greater role in the process of implementing AI and robotics throughout society, because there are also downsides to their application that need to be controlled.
We're talking about artificial intelligence as being a game changer across the public and the private sector. At the same time that we're making artificial intelligence for all of these different applications, we are in the middle of a climate crisis. And we are talking about how we can reduce our carbon emissions. We are talking about how we can reduce our electronic waste. So the two must come together.
Questioning the environmental impact of AI models and identifying real opportunities for taking action is Aimee van Wynsberghe's ambitious goal.
I think empowering consumers to buy ethical products is a key factor in being able to change what's happening in the AI space. And I think what we need, or what consumers need, is choices. And so following in that line, I think we need consumers also to understand how much AI they are already using.
It often remains unclear how high the respective CO2 consumption is when using different devices, also because an exact calculation of all factors involved is almost impossible. According to Google, a Google search causes 0.2 grams of CO2 emissions. Viewed globally, however, the emissions from this service alone add up considerably. Meanwhile, the entire internet and connected devices are responsible for emitting as much CO2 annually as global air travel.
We need to change that way of thinking, that we need to now look at this AI and see how sustainable this AI is. Because it doesn't make sense for us to use an unsustainable technology to tackle problems of sustainability.
To achieve more sustainability awareness, Aimee van Wynsberghe mediates between business, politics, and science. The goal is to establish control mechanisms for a sustainable and fair AI. She offers concrete suggestions with concepts such as a quality mark for AI and robotics, with the aim of creating transparency between companies and consumers.
We need to have more inclusivity on the design team. And I mean specifically, we need to start involving ethicists as a part of the design process. And the job of the ethicist is to uncover, to make sense of, to understand the values that we actually want to be designing this robot to achieve, and then to ask these difficult questions throughout the design process.
That's really great.
The lack of ethical guidelines in the development of robots and AI technologies carries the risk of cementing systematic injustice. What happens when algorithms and historical data reproduce prejudices and reinforce cultural stereotypes? When are power asymmetries created that deny equal opportunities to future generations? Aimee van Wynsberghe calls for a human-centered AI. A responsible development that is needed on a global scale.
I'm thinking about what happens to future generations, and I want to make the world a better place for them when they're growing up. And so I hope that they see that and that they continue that kind of legacy, that they have that same sort of appreciation for the planet that we live on, and that they continue that for their children and for the future generations to come.